Have you experienced this? So you've created something phenomenal. You pour your heart and soul into it. And this could be art, an article you wrote, a podcast, a video, something you designed. And you are just so excited about it and couldn't wait to show the world. And then when you finally do, it's just crickets. Well, if this has happened to you, stay tuned because this week we are going to talk about two things to do when you're starting something new in your creative business to take advantage of those quiet moments. Welcome, I'm Stephanie Weaver, artist and founder of the Positive Painters online creative community, coming to you with art business tips so you can gain focus and action on your art business. Let's get started. Last week, a really good friend of mine called me up completely frustrated with the progress that she's been making on her business. She's started her business in a new direction and she was on day 12 of the new business and product offering. So essentially she was at ground zero, and we all start off at ground zero at some point. And the problem lies in the vicious mindset that has two key debilitating ingredients, and those are patience and comparison. So when I think about patience, I immediately think about Veruca Salt. You remember from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory? So where she's singing, "I want the world, I want the whole world, and I want it now." Well, that's essentially a lack of patience. And I think we all kind of get that every now and then. And the other is the comparison trap, you know, where you're comparing yourself to those artists that are out there that have been producing for 10 or 15 or maybe even 20 years and have developed a following over those 20 years. What you aren't seeing is that it wasn't an overnight success, or if it was, it was because of all those years of small steps and setbacks that got them to the point where they're viewed as a success, which that in turn leads to patience problems. It's a vicious cycle, debilitating cycle that I think we all kind of go through at some point. So the point of that is you got to break the cycle. Instead, I want you to start a new cycle, and that is to give yourself space to learn, evolve, and repeat. Give yourself time to grow. So over the last couple of episodes, I've been really kind of comparing goals to soccer. And I'm going to do that again here to really just drive home how important it is that you do this. Give yourself some space to learn, evolve, and repeat. When I watch professional soccer players, I'm reminded of how it all started. My kids started playing soccer when they were about 3. And they started on these teeny tiny fields with no goalies and no one keeping score except for the parents. They started out on these fields because it allows them to learn the rules, try different positions, score, and also allows them to mess up on a smaller scale to get the redirection from their coaches. As the kids grow, their soccer skills grow and their field size grows, their stamina grows, they get more competitive, and they have more obstacles to overcome to get to the goal. You are starting on the small playing field, and a small supportive audience is a good thing. As you grow, so will your audience. This sounds easy, but mindset changes really never are. But think of it like this. You are learning the playing field, making changes, failing at times, and then learning from those failures. Or if you'd rather call them lessons instead of failures, feel free to do that because it's the same thing. You're learning from your experiences. So I'm telling you, enjoy the small field. Use this time to do the next two big things. The number one thing I want you to do is prepare for growth by putting systems in place. 80% of what we do in our creative business is actually on the business side. So part of the idea of putting a system into place is so that eventually you can give that component of your business that you don't particularly enjoy to someone else to manage. This will give you time to do more of what you love. It's like doing laundry. There's a system. Wash, dry, fold, put away. That's a system. It's a repeatable thing that I can tell you I don't particularly enjoy. So when the time came, I trained the next generation to follow the same process. And guess what? They're doing it what I used to do, and I get to do more of what I like. Always plan for someone else to take on responsibility of what you don't enjoy doing. So to prepare for growth, I want you to do these three following things, okay? These are subsets of prepare for growth. And that is number one, document and refine your process to easily hand off. Number two, set a reminder to review the process you put into place. And this is something that I do almost monthly and quarterly, depending on the process. Number three, start with one system. Get it defined and refined before you add on another system. So example I kind of have there is like Facebook. You know, get the process down before you add on another social media platform. Email workflows is another great example. Get one workflow down before you add on another. Otherwise, you're going to be in this constant game of fixing it, and that's going to take away from your creative time. Just focus on one thing at a time, really define it and refine it until it's at a point where you can easily hand it off to somebody else. The number two thing that I want you to do in these quiet times as you're growing is measure your growth. I want you to set up a process reminder to document the growth of your business. You can do this weekly, monthly. The point is to always document, because those feelings of nobody listening will go away as soon as you see those numbers. I've been measuring my statistics since 2014, and it took me time, but it was about 2018 that I developed a consistent and stable system to track my growth. I'm going to make my system available along with supporting explanatory videos to the Positive Painter Pro members in the next several months. Now, I use tools like Google Analytics, Pinterest Analytics, social media analytics, and more to track growth, which will be included in the tool. But I also want to know what metrics you measure or want to measure. As a result, I've put together a quick survey to better understand the metrics you want to measure so that I can design the tool around what you need. So go to the show notes and enter your feedback about what you'd like to measure in the tool so that we can better develop a system that meets your needs. And please feel free to provide examples. Again, this system will be only available to the Positive Painter Pro members. So if you'd like to become a member of the Positive Painter Pros and gain access to this system and so much more, go to my show notes and click on stephanieweaverartist.com. Just a final note about your growth and in those quiet moments as you're growing. Let me ask you, when you climb up a steep hill or up the Empire State Building or Eiffel Tower up a mountain, when you get to the top, do you stand up there and count the number of steps, or do you just look at the distance that you've climbed? That's your journey, and you're on that journey right now. Give yourself time to grow and build the systems and the stamina that you're going to need to get to your destination. And when you get to the top, you're not going to count these steps, but you will remember them. So enjoy this time, enjoy the journey, grow your systems, develop your systems. I'm Stephanie Weaver, and I look forward to talking with you again next week. Until then, stay safe, happy and healthy, and happy painting.